My topic is about innovation. Leadership through innovation and how innovation can help you in the growth. So, for doing innovation, we need to be innovative and we need to be creative. Yes or no? Without that, innovation will not happen. Machines can't do innovation. Only people can do innovation, right? When I'm going to talk about innovation and creativity, why we are speaking about this, first of all? Why this is so much important? So 3 points, as I've been asked, it's about leadership, it is about growth, it's about strategy. Now, how innovation is going to help you? The point is, I'm not going to show any PPT. Innovation is not just about product. The fact is, in today's world, they say that now the innovation is the only practical source of your competitive advantage. You practically can't compete with your product, you can't compete with your services, and practically you can't compete with your brand today. You need to be innovative, number one. Number two, latest IBM CEO survey, which they conduct every 2 to 3 years, across the globe, covering almost 800 to 900 organizations, right from small to medium to giants. And who are doing? IBM is doing. What they are trying to find out is that what is the leadership competency required at the top, maybe at a VP level, at a GM level, at managing director level, as an entrepreneur, as an owner. And the latest IBM CEO survey for the topmost leadership says that the topmost competency for any leader in this complex business scenario in the 21st century, it's truly global. The topmost leadership competency for today, for the top leader, is creativity. Because without creativity, you cannot have innovation. So number one, innovation is the only competitive advantage you have today. Number two, it is the first requirement for a leader. Number three, a very famous quote from Steve Jobs, the innovation distinguishes between a leader and a follower. Exactly 2 to 3 years back, I am part of Ahmedabad Management Association and part of Baroda Management Association also. And in Baroda, I am from Baroda. In 2012, we invited the then IMA president, All India Management Association president, Mr. Shiva Kumar. At that time, he was the managing director of Nokia. And that conference was in month of May. When he was with us, and it was a full-day conference, after a leadership of one decade, almost 10 years, number one position as a handset in mobile market in the world, they just slipped to number two position and Samsung became number one. I'm talking about month of April and May 2012. And from the audience, somebody asked him, "Sir, what happened to Nokia? Why you slipped to number two position after almost 10 years of leadership? What was the reason?" And his one word answer was innovation. So what is innovation? Why it is so much important today? And what do you need as far as innovation is concerned? Number one, innovation is not just a product strategy or a process strategy. It is the way you build your organization. You need to define what is my USP. And maybe your USP of today is not a guarantee that tomorrow that USP is going to give you business. Absolutely. There is a big problem there. So the point is, why innovation? Whatever we are discussing, and most of the time what we do is always inbox thinking. It is all about IQ. It is from head, it is from intellect. But my friend, the meaning of IQ maybe in the 20th century was intelligence quotient. Unfortunately, in this era of Google, you know, for anything we know, we search on Google. Om Google I Namaha, and something will come out in 24 seconds. And unfortunately, IQ has become information quotient today. But to be competitive, for a growth, for a leader, the real meaning of IQ in 21st century is innovation quotient. And why? And for what? So the fact is, you need to think out of box. You have to be creative. Because what Albert Einstein very famously said, that you can't solve today's problems with yesterday's solutions. Logic will take you from A to B, but imagination will take you from A to Z and beyond that. He again said that imagination is more important than knowledge. Most of the time, we being an entrepreneur, we are too much thinking about the logic, about intellect. And innovation will not happen from that. So again, I would like to quote one more thing. There was a latest survey on creativity. When IBM CEO survey says that you need creativity, there was another survey about creativity quotient, what they call it is a CQ. And the surprising things have emerged from that survey. Again, it was global by an authentic agency across the world. And they came out with the statistics. They say that when our age group is up to 10 years, we are highly creative. Our creativity quotient is as high as 90. We are in the age group of 11 to 15, our creativity quotient goes down from 90 to 60. And from 15 to 20, creativity quotient further goes down from 60 to 40. And from 21 to 25 age group, our creativity quotient is only 20. But the most surprising and the disturbing fact is, once we cross the age group, once we cross our age beyond 25, the CQ, the creativity quotient, is only 2. Only 2. So from 90 to 2. This is what the fact and the research says. And my personal experience and my personal research says, once you are married, it is in minus. Okay, jokes apart. So the fact is that now when the creativity quotient is going down, how can you remain creative? And if you are not creative, how can you innovate? How can an organization innovate? So the fact is, when you are talking about innovation, as recently the President of United States, Mr. Barack Obama, very famously said, innovation and education is the real currency for the 21st century. Bill Gates says the pace of innovation is scary in 21st century. Today, you cannot compete without innovation. And Jack Welch, the famous CEO of GE, said, if you don't have competitive advantage, please do not compete, just copy and live a mediocre life. So question is whether we really want to lead and whether we really want to have a growth. And if you want to think like that, innovation is must. It is not an option for you. It's as simple as that. Now the point is, how can we really innovate? The fact is, too much insistence, and unfortunately in our education system, where the too much focus is there on the memory, mugging, the syllabus is not updated since last 60 to 70 years. So we are killing creativity in schools and colleges, and bureaucracy, red tapism, hierarchy kills when the person enters into the corporate world or maybe in a professional world. How can we really become creative and innovative? And if we can't do that, how can our organization do that? That's a question mark. So the fact is, and there is a good news, that big corporates and multinationals, they find it very, very difficult to innovate. The good news is that MSME, the small companies, the startup, they are well placed. The latest McKinsey report says that the innovations are actually happening by the smaller companies. And that's why the big companies then take over there. So there is an opportunity. But the bad news is, most of the MSME, they are not doing it. They are not innovating. I'll give you another statistics. McKinsey report says that in 1990, the technology share in the world GDP was 38%. And in 2012, the technology share in world GDP increased from 38% to 58%. And by 2020, it is going to be 70%. As we all know that last 5 to 10 years, how our life is now technology driven. Our small gadget, we do everything. Booking, traveling, transportation, banking, insurance, everything is done by technology. Yes or no? The life is changed. Now that is going to happen more and more. So the life is changing, the customers are changing, the lifestyle is changing. But are we changing? Are we updating? Are we innovating? That's a question mark. So, what is the situation today? I being part of, and you will be, I don't know whether you know or not, but India is the only country which has declared this decade, 2010 to 20, as a decade of innovation. The government of India decided that better late than never, but we have what we call it as a National Innovation Council, which is basically formulating a strategy for creating a roadmap of for innovation in India. And I'm lucky that I'm part of that team, which was earlier headed by Dr. Sam Pitroda. The stalwarts are there. We have our office and planning commission in Delhi. So we are innovating, and it's difficult. You can innovate in a company or you can innovate in a product. But innovating a country like India, where the population is 1.2 billion, it's tough, it's difficult. So there is a roadmap. A lot of things are happening. But coming back to MSME, the situation is tough. We take our customers for granted. अरे यार 35 साल से बिजनेस कर रहा हूँ कुछ नहीं होता है आई नो व्हाट टू डू मेरा कस्टमर कहीं नहीं जाएगा मेरे पास ही आने वाला है कुछ नहीं होता है एंड सडनली वी रियलाइज दैट डायमेंसी हैज एंटर्ड और सम न्यू टेक्नोलॉजी हैज कम एंड वी आर नोवेयर पोटाश जेवो आजनो आ वर्तमान छे पोटाश जेवो आजनो आ वर्तमान छे अने कमनसीबे आपणी ऋणी दुकान छे साहेब The fact is, it's not here in India, but it's across the globe, that the top Fortune 500 companies, you will be surprised to know that within next 5 years, 50% of companies are killed and closed down. Not going out of 500 list, but they are actually closed down. They are killed. Because the pace of technological innovation is so fast that the companies are getting killed. So where are we today? Innovations are happening at such a speed and pace that you can't even imagine. Isliye when I'm talking to few of my clients as a consultant and as a part of the strategist, and when I say that, please understand that this technology is not going to give you any lead in next 1 year. They don't understand. And then when it happens, they are nowhere. I'll give you two things that as far as innovation is concerned. The first strategy is technology push innovation, which is invariably happening from global to local. The MNCs are driving. Of course, it is done by small player, but then they take over it. So pager gone, fax gone. Telegram gone, typewriter gone, and you can't do anything because technology has replaced them. And you can't do much. If you are in that business and if you don't understand it, it's your problem, it's not their problem. And many things are going to happen now, please understand. In the way we do the business. The second strategy, what we call it as a business model innovation, which is actually a marketing pull strategy. When previously, in 1991, under Narasimha Rao as a prime minister, Dr. Manmohan Singh started what we call it as liberalization policy. What it was LPG. What was LPG? What is LPG? It is not liquefied petroleum gas. It is basically liberalization, privatization, and globalization. When they started in India in 1991, what were the top three companies in India in refrigeration? Apna garma freeze hoy na? What were the top three companies in India? Kelvinator, Voltas, Godrej. Voltas was a Tata company, Godrej is a big company, Kelvinator was a big company. Now, in 2015, which are the top three companies in India? Samsung, LG, and? Samsung, LG, and? IBM. So the point is, no Indian companies are in top three. A small Korean country, LG and Samsung, they have got 80% market share across the world. What specially they are doing? That's what we call it as a business model innovation. It's not about product. It's about how you do a business. How you are close to your customer. Innovation comes from capturing the voice of a customer. Do you understand? Do we understand our customer? That's why way back in 1974, the famous management guru Peter Drucker said, 1974 he said, for any business he said, there are only two functions. First, marketing. Second, innovation. Unfortunately, we forgot innovation. He says, rest all our processes. There are only two functions, marketing and innovation. And as the godfather of marketing, Dr. Philip Kotler says, that marketing is not an art of selling what you make, but knowing what to make. Innovation is all about capturing voice of a customer. And I was recently with him for 3 days in Kellogg. He is a distinguished professor at Kellogg University near Chicago, Northwestern University. There was a global innovation conference. They selectively invite only 150 people across the globe. It is by invitation only. I'm lucky that I was the only one from India. They selectively invited people. And the fact is, there were stalwarts. Dr. Philip Kotler was there. The head of Google in cloud was there. Toyota, VP, the president of Unilever. They were all top shots. And it was a 3 days conference. 27, 28, and 29th May. And of course, the last day, Dr. Philip Kotler was a speaker. And he said, we have to move from 4P to 3P. What are the 4Ps in the marketing? Price, place, product, and promotion. Yeah. So he said, if you think too much about a small business, it's 4P. But the world has changed. And he has given the new concept 3P. The 3Ps are, first, the profit. Second, people. And third, planet. Why this last two? Profit, people, and planet. Because today the world is facing maximum two problems across the globe. The first is terrorism, and the second is climate change. Terrorism is a product of people management, and climate change is a product and the consequences and the reaction of how we have handled this entire earth in last 50 or 100 years. So what are the strategies? Because there are a lot of new avenues. For example, Europe and America have stopped investing much into the other areas because now they are because of the terrorism and planet problems. They are too much investing into these two areas. Are we ready? There are going to be terrorism-proof products and lifestyle. A huge scope is there. The point is that when we discussed with the small people that, look, the things are changing. This product is not going to be relevant. The technology is changing. The customer will not accept this. The market is different. MNCs are entering. and 9 out of 10 times they live in their past glory. Kuch nahi hota hai. 35 saal se business kar rahe. Kuch fark nahi padta hai. And suddenly one day they realize they are nowhere. Do you need a consultant to tell you that what is going to happen in your business? Dushyant Kumar, a Hindi poet, famously said, Tumhare paon ke niche zameen nahi. Tumhare paon ke niche zameen nahi. Aur kamal hai, phir bhi tumko yakin nahi. You need someone to tell you that tomorrow this product or this business is not going to work. And now the pace is so fast. In 20th century, there was an era of closed innovation. What is happening in your company, in your R&D, you are not knowing because it was kept secret. But that strategy failed miserably. Most of the innovations failed in 20th century. Why? Because it was a closed innovation process. Now the companies are opening up. People are getting ideas across the globe. It is a process of open innovation. And things are happening. If you read latest McKinsey report that how the 13 technology are going to, and what they call it as a disruptive technology, the way we do the business in the world are going to be changed drastically in next 2 to 3 years. Read that report. How the things are going to shape. Internet of the things, 3D technology and the 3D printing technology, engineered plastics, nanotechnology, biotechnology, robotics, lot of things are going to change. Are we ready? Are we prepared? That's a question mark. I'll give you one more example. Last year, suddenly I was asked by PMO office that there is a competition in Russia where more than 17 countries are participating, Europe and Russia and China. And I was asked the 2 days back that you have to lead youngsters from IIT Delhi as a mentor and leader. It was a 6 days competition. 17 countries, 7 juries from different countries, 3,000 delegates. And you know what, after 6 days? Team India won the Innovation Award. Why? We Indians are highly creative, but we need to give them space. Our bureaucratic mindset, I am the boss, I am the leader, baal safed ho gaya hai, 35 saal kaam anubhav hai, isliye main kehta hun aisa kar. Sorry, innovations will not happen like that. You need a mentor, you need to groom someone. You need to encourage new ideas. So the bright spot is we need to create an attitude of learning. Unfortunately, in India, training, mentoring, coaching is considered as cost. You know, famous joke, a CFO says to the CEO that, oh, what if we train and people leave? And CEO says, what if we don't train and the people stay in my company? This is the fact. 90% company don't train their employees. And if you don't train, do you want, how can the good ideas come, the new ideas come? We need to create an attitude of learning. Innovations happen from learning. It's an attitude. And learning comes from passion. It's identifying new things, generating new ideas. Na has ke seekhe hai, na ro ke seekhe hai. ना हंस के सीखे हैं ना रो के सीखे हैं. हम जो कुछ भी सीखे हैं किसी के हो के सीखे हैं. आर यू पैशनेट अबाउट समथिंग? देन इनोवेशंस विल हैपन. सी कोडेक, 20th सेंचुरी जायंट नंबर वन, दे डिड नॉट रियलाइज दैट डिजिटल टेक्नोलॉजी इज गोइंग टू किल देम एंड इट एक्चुअली किल्ड देम. इसलिए वन सक्सेस इज नॉट अ गारंटी टूडे. हवा में ताश का घर नहीं बनता, रोने से बिगड़ा मुकद्दर नहीं बनता. हवा में ताश का घर नहीं बनता, रोने से बिगड़ा मुकद्दर नहीं बनता. जिंदगी जीने का हौसला रखो यारो, क्योंकि एक जीत से कोई सिकंदर नहीं बनता. यू टू कंटिन्यूअसली प्रोड्यूस सक्सेस, सक्सेस एंड ग्रोथ. वी नीड टू क्रिएट अ कल्चर ऑफ इनोवेशन एंड क्रिएटिविटी इन अवर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. एंड आई टेल यू, इट्स अ राइट टाइम. The fastest growing economy today is India. When I was recently invited by University of Texas in Dallas, and I was invited by TAI. TAI is world's biggest organization of entrepreneurship. Very active chapter in Ahmedabad, very active chapter in Hyderabad, Pune, Bangalore, Delhi. I was invited in Silicon Valley, and they asked me that you talk about startup opportunities in India. I tell you, there were 200 people in the audience, and they were quite excited about 100 smart cities in India. They are ready to invest. So the point is, are we ready? Make in India is the next big thing coming. Are we ready? Are we ready? Whether people are ready? Are we creating a culture? What we need is our role. There are two kinds of mindset. One is a business mindset. Second is self-employed mindset. If you see that if you are not there in the business, or one day or two day, whether your business can run without you on auto mode, if no, you are not a leader. You are only a manager. Please understand one thing. You are only a manager. You are not a leader. Leader doesn't require to put his head into the normal day-to-day operation. The role of a leader is to create more leaders, my friend. And then, out of you, one can become another Gautam Adani or Karsan Bhai Patel or Dhirubhai Ambani. So I would like to close now. I would like to only say that we need to create a new thinking, a new mindset. Soch ko badalna hoga. Innovation is all about, you know, trying something new and different. Having guts, ready to accept failures and mistakes. Dushyant Kumar ji, again I'm quoting, he said, innovation is like, kaise aasman mein surakh nahi ho sakta. Kaise? Aasman mein surakh nahi ho sakta. Ek patthar to tabiyat se uchhalo yaro. Ek patthar to uchhalne ki himmat honi chahiye. So we need to change that mindset. Thoda sa thinking. You don't have to change everything. You have to change the direction, the way you think. Huh? Soch ko badlo to sitare badal jayenge. Soch ko badlo to sitare badal jayenge. Nazariye ko badlo to nazare badal jayenge. Samandar ki kyun chinta karte ho, dosto? Sirf kashti ki disha ko badlo to kirare badal jayenge. We have to change the way we think and we do the business. And today, fortunately, I tell you, the next generation, Generation Y, the second entrepreneurship generation, they are ready to do it. They accept it. They know that we need to do it. They have mentors and coaches. Because you alone can't do. Our biggest problem is we want to do everything together. You know, we don't want to delegate. We think that mentor is, you know, mentor is not costing you. He is your growth partner. Please understand this. Because the way the technology is moving, you can't do everything together. It's not possible. So what I want to do is, we have to start. And I tell you, next 3 to 4 years are too good for India. And if you can't do it in next 2 to 3 years, you will miss the opportunity. Are we ready? That's the point. So my point, and what I want to tell you is that for me, Make in India is all about make India proud. Its growth doesn't mean only business and numbers and profits and money. The real growth is that, can I make my India proud? That's the growth. So mera kehne ka tatpariya itna hi hai, and I will close now, that humko kahin na kahin ye mindset change karna padega. Jab India ki rank niche utar rahi hai, to thoda takleef bhi hona chahiye. And I tell you, there is a huge opportunity now. So I will close with 4 lines again from Dushyant Kumar, with this theme given to me. And why I'm talking like this today is that sirf hangama khada karna mera maksad nahi. Sirf hangama khada karna mera maksad nahi. Meri koshish hai ki yeh surat badalni chahiye. Mere sine mein nahi to tere sine mein sahi. Mere sine mein nahi to tere sine mein sahi. Ho kahin bhi aag, lekin yeh aag jalni chahiye. Innovation should make India proud. And it must happen from us and from all of us. Thank you so much.